So let's lay down on your back. Hips are rooted into the mat and knees are bent. Take a deep breath in. And as you exhale, relax your shoulders on the mat and relax your sacrum into the floor. Deep breath in. Exhale. Deep breath in. Exhale. One more breath. And then exhale. You're going to place your hands at the back of your head. Take a deep breath in. Open your chest. Lift your tummy in and up. And as you exhale, close your elbows. Lift your shoulders, head, and squeeze your abs towards your spine. Inhale, lengthen your back. Head down. Deep breath in. Close your elbows. Lift. Exhale. Exhale, head down one last time. Deep breath in. Exhale, head down. Relax your arms by your side. And move your hips right, your hips left. Together with your knees moving along, just releasing your spine and your pelvis. And then once you're done, then you're going to rock and release. Deep breath in. Two more counts. Last breath. And then slide your right leg forward. So you keep using this feeling of elongating your spine when you do your leg slide. So later when you do single leg stretch, you remember that we are not flicking the leg, we are not shifting the pelvis, we are simply elongating the spine and the leg as we do the upward. Exhale, leg back, inhale. Exhale, back center, deep breath in. One more each side. Last one. And then exhale, finish with the left side. Come on in. And then you're going to bring your right knee up. Inhale in tabletop position. Exhale, leg down. Same principle. The sacrum is stable, the lumbar spine is stable. You're not changing the bone, you're just simply lengthening your abdominal as you breathe in and you exhale down. So you engage the right muscles. One more time and exhale, switch leg. Deep breath in. Two more counts. Last one. And then once you're done, you're ready for the hundreds. Take your right knee up. Take your left knee up. Take a deep breath in. Exhale, head and shoulders off the mat. Legs up and let's begin. Exhale. Last one, two, three, four, five. Exhale, head down. Stretch your arms, stretch your legs. Flex your feet. Open all your ten toes. Lengthen your tummy. All right, ready for roll up. Now, I usually have tight lower back. So for me to be able to engage right away and feel like my abdominal is working, I need to do a couple of, you know, light one before my spine releases, and then the roll up feels like a flow. So stretch your calves, open your 10 toes, take a deep breath in. I open my legs a little bit apart so my hips doesn't feel tight either. Roll, right, exhale. So small for the first one. Deep breath in, roll the pelvis. And exhale, head down. Deep breath in. All right, on the third one, let's see. Yeah, feel a little looser. So the point is not to bounce or to, you know, force the stretch. It's to let it happen naturally on the third and the fourth, and your spine will eventually open. That's why you keep moving. And it makes it easier for you to recover and always come back to your body. Inhale. It's very important that you keep your toes open so your calf muscle release and the hamstring can engage and elongate, so which also elongates your spine. Two more. Last one. And release. Ah, knees bend. Sway to the right. Sway to the left. And then we'll bring the knees towards each other, sway the knees to the right. Always give your spine time to open. You know, muscles are like that. Sometimes they need a little bit of love, and then they function back to what you like them to do, but be nice. All right, we're going to start with the left leg today. So press the left knee towards the chest, elongate the left right leg out. Then extend your leg up towards the ceiling, flex point, circle, reverse, oops, that was a weird reverse. And then we point the toe, hold, tummy up towards the spine, crossover, oops, need space. Inhale, make sure you have plenty of space to move your leg. Two more. Last one. Reverse. And then knee towards the chest. Press down. Flex the foot. Just stretch a little bit of the outer hip there. Come back center, and then release. Flex the left foot, the right knee into the chest. Tummy up towards the spine, extend the leg, and then flex. And then we circle, reverse. Point and hold. Make sure you have plenty of space for this leg as well. Crossover. Exhale. One, reverse, last one, and then into the chest, just do a little stretching on the side. here to just stretch out the hip back in and then back to center. Exhale up to sitting. Deep breath in. And we roll back. Exhale. Make sure you lift. No matter how long you've done your rolling leg roll, there's always a little new way of looking at it. So pinch a little bit the sit bones, lift the waistline, roll, open the spine. Exhale. Two more. Last one. Single leg stretch. Both knees towards the chest. Left knee stays into the chest. Right leg goes out. Left hand towards the ankle. Right hand towards the knee. I'm already out with the right leg. And then exhale, head up. Lower the leg or keep it higher here. If you have this click in your pelvis, better to keep your leg up rather than going all the way down for now. Deep breath in. And we go. Exhale. Inhale. So don't shove your leg out. Just keep it open, stretch, no lock of the knee. Gentle. One more. Finish on the left side. Both knees in towards the chest. Move the head to the right. And then come back center. Exhale, head up, tummy in. Exhale, double leg stretch. Soft knees straighten, exhale. Last one. And relax the neck down. If your neck feeling tight, stretch. And then we're ready for scissors. Both legs up. Grab on the right leg. Take a deep breath in. So again, if you have this click, when you move your legs away from your spine, keep your range small. I'm gonna go here. Breathe. Don't pull so hard if you feel tight. Just soften your spine. And we go. So it's a catch to switch leg. One more. Finish with the left. Both legs up, knees to the chest. Almost there. Two more to go. Hands at the back of the head, legs up, point. If flex feels strong for you, go for flex. I keep this very small, again, because of the tightness of the lower back and the pelvis. Plus, I'm still reconnecting with my left lower abs, which is a little bit dormant, so taking it easy. All right, crisscross, knees bent, lift the right shoulder, bring the armpit to the opposite knee, come back center. And both knees in, and relax. Stretch the tummy. Ooh, that was good. And then we're ready. Come up sitting. Spine stretch. Grab the feet. Stretch and bend the legs. Wiggle on the pelvis. And try to stay as upright as you can. Don't force the locking. Don't force your leg by locking your knees. Keep the knees soft. Arms up. Deep breath. Exhale. I'm going to place my hands here. I'm going to pull myself forward. Exhale. Last. And last. I found that when I put my hands on my back like that, I can get a little bit more bend in my spine. Something to explore. Okay. Let's do this. We'll start with some spinal rotation. And then the arms. You know, again, when the spine is stiff, you need it to give it time to move again. All right, stretch the legs. And relax. Oh. Okay, on the knees. A little bit of cat-cow, spine release. Flex the toes. And then we're gonna go down. First one. Chest down. Settle down on the floor. Shoulders melt down on the back and under your shoulder. Huge inhalation. Go small. Side kick series. Lay down on your side. Bring your head in line with your shoulders, shoulders in line with your pelvis. Bring your right leg up, hold it, and then lift the bottom leg. I'm doing long breaths.
And then relax up and down with the top leg.
Hold your head up, your right leg, touch your toe, and exhale. And then flex your top foot, we go forward. One more. And this one. And reverse. And then lay down on your tummy.
Last, fold your arms, forehead down, grasshopper.
Push, other side. Lay down on your bicep,
head in line with your shoulder in line with your ribs and pelvis. Pick the top leg left side and up and down with the top bottom leg. I'm doing long breath. Hold and then top leg. About 10 reps. And then bring your legs diagonal forward.
Hold your head up, top leg up to the height, little turn out. One more. And then leg a little bit behind the top leg, the bottom leg, and then circle. And lay down. Okay, teaser. Now that's gonna be interesting. So let's try it. Nice and slow. Let all the air out. Deep breath in. Lift the head, lift the shoulders, lift the legs, and then exhale. All right, so my lower back was not in contact with the mat when I came up. Well, that's fine, but I still felt my abdominal engaged. I haven't done that for like weeks. Exhale. Two more counts. Last one. And exhale. Ah, wasn't so bad. Let's finish with sit-up.
Hand inside the legs. You're gonna bring your feet up to navel height, clap. Roll back. One, two, three. One, two, three. One, two, three. One more time. And then cross the legs. Hands at the back of the head. Take a stretch.
Elbow up, elbow down. Switch.